Right. Yeah, come on, guys. Shush. Yeah, I think it'd be a good idea. Yeah. Win 7-ups.
Akbar!
Right, let's get this sorted out. I've done it. I'm already there. I'm sitting there now. I'm just looking at my feed on Twitch. Yep, logged in. My channel, top right. Well, I'm on here, so it's got. A minute. Yeah, I'm watching now. I'm on my profile on Twitch, and it's. Edit. Yeah, I've got it now. It's got title this broadcast. Wait a minute, search for, this is title this broadcast streaming broadcast language. Broadcast language mode. Yeah, I've clicked on edit. I don't know. Button. What do you mean button? Yeah. Well, I'm going to feel on the top right. It's got. I don't know what's going on. Yeah. I've got. Wait a minute. Yeah. I'm on my laptop, right? I've signed into my Twitch feed. Right, I'm coming, just signing in and out, right? We're gonna fucking eventually does it. Right, there we go. Right, and now it's got. Yeah, but it's got. No, it's not on the top right. I've got. It's got Mustafashag, but it's in. It won't let me click it. It's in the message bit. Right? Right, wait a minute. Let's see what's. Channels. No, I'm not in channel. Well, I'm on my profile. There's my profile. I can edit my profile there. No, I don't want to change any of that. Done. Right. So, must have a sh. No, no. I mean, videos. What's that? Clips for. Right. On my profile here, on my fucking channel here, what I've got. Is the channel itself that I'm broadcasting, and it says F1 2016 WRM SRM7 Canada. So that's what I put on the broadcast when I put the Xbox on. Now below that, it's giving me the edit or share. So I push edit, right? I pushed edit, and it comes up title this broadcast, and it says F1 2016 Round 7 Canada, streaming, search for a game streaming. Right. Now what do you want me to put in there? F1 2016, click on it, yep, done. You'll be able to, I think it's doing something, should be able to. Just checking now. Yeah, I've got it. Yeah, I've got it, like, I think I've done it. I think I've done everything you've said there, like, so. Right, so I can come, I can get out of this this one now because it's running now, isn't it? Nah. No. No. What's this for? He's for his penalty. He's getting 20 seconds. Simple. No, there's no argument. There's no point this or point that. It's 20 fucking seconds. Right. Well, I'll stay here. Am I rocking and rolling? Excellent. Oh yeah, it says there, Possibly Glad is now hosting you. There we go. Awesome. Yeah. I will now get beer in. Right. Right, there we go. Back. You there, beer? Alright, cool. Right, we're live anyway. We're streaming. I'm streaming through it also through polls as well, so. It could be rock and roll. We will be starting soon, folks. Don't worry, viewers. We're just getting everything organised, ready for this exciting race here in Canada. Looking forward to this tonight. I have no idea. I have no idea. No. No, he's not. It's Thursday. He's going to get his trial. I've done it. It's up to Paul or whoever he wants to come in. I don't run. I have nothing to do with the running of the Tuesday. I just do the Saturday one. Excellent turnout. 18 drivers. Do you hear that, folks? We've got 18 on the grid. Could be quite eventful. And we know what Canada's like. Rain. Yes, that's it. Yeah, you want AIs on medium because then you don't get the little people cheating. Yes, the cheaters. No. Yeah, of course. Well, like I say, we usually do the build-up, don't we? So, you know, get all tuned up, get my little vocal cords tuned. I need a cup of tea first. In fact, I'm going to put this in my... Yeah, cup of tea to right. Yes, us commentators, we need a cup of tea. That's how we can keep the entertainment flowing. Keep you all you on the edge of your seats of all this exciting viewing that is coming up ahead. Feel free to post any little comments in a little side box there because I do have my laptop on and I can see live messages. Okay, folks? Just to let you know, I do, we're up to 4 viewers at the moment. This proceedings will begin soon. We're just waiting for possibly even more drivers. We have 18, because it does say 20, but there is 2 stewards and commentators, as you will find out. Ah. But first of all, the most important thing, priority, and make a cup of tea. Got to have a cup of tea. Ah, damn it. Well, I don't know which part of the world all you viewers are sitting in, but up in Newcastle right now, it's bloody cold. It's not very warm in the old Newcastle Geordie land where I'm on. Canny bag of chuda when the board comes in. That's a canny lass. Tea, sugar, and milk to finish it off. That's my vocals suitably wetted. I used to do with the Kinect, but I've sold my Kinect. But I will be getting another one, so you will be getting a view of the old Shaggy in the future. A message from NTT Silver, but Silver, I really don't want to go and look at messages from, because it pauses the menu, pauses the feed. I don't want to do that. Don't want to do that. Go onto my Twitch feed and you can do it that way. Oh, quick, need to visit to go and drain the python, folks. Mic on, mic off. Is it? You're the one, you're the host, so you can see the best. Well, I'll tell you ones that are red on mine. Is sexy, sim. Fat boy. Yeah. Yeah. That's because he's on the pikey freaking connection though. What do you expect? No disrespect button, but you really need to get some decent broadbands on. You really do. Yep. No, I'm just waiting till they go. Yeah, looks like it's going to be a cracking race, Canada. Hope it rains. I hope it rains like it never rained before. I hope the heavens open up. Just make a storm. Just put a storm on. That'd be massive. I think the viewers would appreciate it. It would give us some excitement as well. Ah. That stream looks pretty clear, like. It doesn't look like. That's pretty good quality, actually. I'm happy with that. Well done, Virgin. Oh, the, well, what ones are left? Really? Yeah, I suppose I is I. Of course I am Lewis Hamilton. I do like the look of the new Mercedes though. I love that. I've seen it. It's on Fingerby before. It looks sleek as hell, mate. It looks lovely. It does look nice. I can't wait for the new game. Try to see the new cars. Yeah, there is. Yeah, some nice. It's going to be some nice cars, I think, this year, colour wise. And even McLaren have changed their colour, haven't they? I believe they've went orange. I know. I mean, they're really standing out now, aren't they? Red Ferrari, yeah. Blue frequency, yeah. The blue red. Okay, hell, aye. Be quite a mixture. I can't really check my messages because it just pauses the vid, so. Yep, I lock it off 20. That's the idea. Right. Yes, feel free, folks. Anybody's watching, any comments on the side, I will relay that on to all the viewers. Give us your idea who you think's going to win. That'd be a good idea. Your predictions would be a nice. Whether you wanted it to be a nice dry, fast race or accidents in a wet, maybe. We'll be starting shortly. We will be starting shortly. It looks like 10 out of 20, so, and the clock's ticking down, so I will go green. It looks like it's all go here in Canada. The clock is a ticking. Oh, there's Withy Man. Oh. Ding 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 ding. And yes, welcome folks, it's round 7 of the World Online Racing League season, and it's looking good and it's looking tasty. And commentators tonight is myself, Mustafashag. And co-commentating is your racing guru himself, Mr. Kebab Beer.
Well, hello there. Yes, BK on the Xbox, Beer and Kebab, the racing guru. And welcome to Tuesday WOR Race Night. And tonight, we are at Canada. Oh, Canada.
Oh, yeah.
So the first thing we're going to we're going to check the weather because it always rains.
Yes.
Is it going to rain tonight?
Rain. Come on.
We hope
rain,
so.
Rain.
It's just
rain,
loading
rain.
Up now.
We want rain.
Black screen. Well, here we go. Oh. Sounds like dry qualifying. No pitter-patter. I can't hear any pitter-patter with rain.
Can I just
say,
it looks like it's going to be action-packed. We've got full grid apart from two. So 18 drivers all vying for that place.
Right, come on.
Be
come
interesting
on.
Qualifying.
Tender hooks, weather, right, weather. Oh, it's raining.
Oh,
it's
look,
raining.
It's raining.
Yay.
Oh, it's heavy rain for
it's a dry race. It's a dry race, but it's a wet qualifying.
Oh, what a dry, a wet race.
It's a monster. The interesting thing is, the rain is gonna peter out during qualifying, which is interesting. So that means that the guys, they might be able to qualify on intermediates as opposed to full wets.
The last 10 minutes is going to be light rain.
Oh, you're going to see a barrage of cars going down the pit lane, I reckon, then.
They'll probably put a banker in there at a waterfall, and then they'll...
Interesting to see. Right then, well, let's have a quick rundown of tonight's drivers. In no particular order, we've got WOR Paul, Pure Venoms, Knitch, Horn Dog, With You Man, we got Red Bull, Calvano, Hectic Visions, Marley, Fat Boy, It's Your Dad, Kai, Button, Sexy, Simon, It's Your Mum, Ben, and we have Forrester, and of course we have Swizz, and not forgetting the Baby Maker, Mr. Posglad. So that's the full lineup tonight. Yeah. Should be an absolute
sure
cracker.
Is.
Right, first question first, Skinny. Let's do some predictions.
My prediction. Right. Okay. Now, I'm really going to stick my neck out, and I'm going to say Mr. Kai is the one to watch here. I think he's got abundance of pace, and I think he's going to take it to Fat Boy.
Well,
our championship leader.
Yeah, it's going to be a cracker, mate. This to me could well be the race of the season to date. I think it will be. Fat Boy, as usual, is my pre-race favourite. But there is a but this week. He is carrying a 20-second penalty carried over from the last race.
Yes,
at Monaco.
He is.
So whether that will make a difference, I don't know. One thing's for sure. I've been practicing with Fat Boy during the week. He is insanely fast around here. He is very, very quick. So he could well pull
that
out those 20
seconds.
Seconds,
I think it's going to be enough.
It's big. We'll have to wait and see. And again, looking through the order, anyway, we've got Pure Venoms, always in with a shout. Very, very quick. Posglad. Pos is going to be going for it this week. He's had back-to-back podiums. He's finished third. He's finished second. I know he wants first place. And he will rag that car to try and get those extra few tenths of a second out of it. So he's going to be up there. You've got Kai, of course. Mm-hmm. You've got It's Your Mum, the dark horse. He's always there, thereabouts.
Mm-hmm. That's it.
And also, of course, Paul as well. One of the most consistent guys, consistent drivers in WOR.
Yeah,
and he gets quicker with every race. Sooner or later, he's going to win one. I've got no doubt about it. Hectic, of course, the winner at Spain. Didn't have quite such a good race at Monaco. I think he had a couple of incidents there. Still got good points, mind you. I think he got fifth, I believe, but he's going to be quick around here too. He's just got genuine pace. And the mid-pack, this is it, because there's not really a mid-pack. They're all good. They're all quick. You know what I mean? It's just, you know, you've got Marley, you've got Red Bull, you've got Withy, you've got Horn Dog. You know?
Well, another good thing that I need to point out as well, this track, it's pretty good at being able to overtake.
Oh,
there's places that you can really go for it.
And
so I'm expecting a lot of action.
Well, the guy I've forgotten, of course, Mr. Forrester. First winner on the Saturday. We know Forrester of old. Believe me, folks, he's quick. He is quick.
Yeah.
Make no bones about it.
He's very quick. He's very, very quick.
So, yeah, it's going to be a fascinating one. And just for people who haven't watched this before, who are either watching us now live on Twitch or will be watching us on the YouTube channel over the next few days, we run 50% races with short qualifying, dynamic weather. As you can see, it's raining. And we also run the strict corner cutting because we don't like corner cutters or cheeks. We don't tolerate them. No. We want good, clean driving.
You can use assist if you want. If you don't want to use assist, that's
totally
it.
Totally. And if you want to come
the
and have a look at what we do,
the only thing we ban is brake assist.
Yeah. And if you want to come and have a look at what we do, you can come visit us on Facebook on the WOR, which is World Online Racing Facebook page. We're also on Twitter, and of course the YouTube channel, which is the place for all our races, which is World Online Racing. You can find that. Stick out in your search bar and you'll find us. And we're running a Tuesday league, as you can see. We also do the 100% league on a Saturday. And a third league is in the planning stages. So if you want to come and join us, by all means, we trial every week, every couple of weeks. We'll have a trial race for new drivers to come in so we can road test you, have a look, etc., etc. So if you're
depending
interested,
on which division you
come
want
and
to
join
be
us.
In.
Yep.
That's
come,
it. If you only want 50%, there's 50% there. If you want 100%, there's 100% there. I'm not too sure what the format for the third division will be yet, but I'm sure we'll be coming up with some good ideas.
Okay. Well, we've got some lap time set. We've got Buttons at the 126.7, which is a solid time actually on the wets. And Hectic's gone faster, the 125.9. I think anything sub 127 in full wets is actually very quick.
I'm staying on board with here, Fat Boy, because he's basically the boy, the one that everybody's chasing at the moment.
Yeah.
So we'll
it's
see
your
what kind of lap he puts in.
It's Your Mum's just done a 126.6, which is a very quick time indeed on the wets. So yeah, those three have, it's hectic, mum and button at the moment are setting the pace. Look at this, we've got some changes there. Paul has done a 125.871, just 1/10 down on button. Button has just gone provisional pole with a 125.85.
Right, we're just about to come across the start finish straight, we're coming down to it now. We're aboard Mr. Fat Boy here, our current World Championship leader. He seems to have basically had a hold of this league.
He's taken it by the scruff of the neck, isn't he? He started off with the win in
really
Melbourne.
He's got a grip of it.
And the only race he didn't win was Spain, because he came second. So he maximised his points there, near as damn it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Kai set a 126.1. Now, just a quick heads up, Skinny. Just had Jeff in my ear. Apparently the radar is clearing. It's going to be light rain in the next few minutes, so the rain's going to ease off. Be interesting to see if the cars come in, switch over onto the intermediate tyres, which I'm sure they will do if the condition suits it.
Right, well, Fat Boy's just done a 25.2 first sector. I don't know where that compares to the other ones.
That's the quickest so far. Sector. That is the quickest so far.
That's the quickest so far. Yeah. Right. Oh, and he's blowing it. Totally missed.
Well,
the
just to let you know, hectic's gone quicker. It. Hectic's just regained provisional pole, the 125.5.
Yeah.
And Ben's gone second. Nice. Ben's gone second with the 125.8.
Yes.
Button's
nice.
Now gone pole. Look at that time. A 125 flat in pole position so far. That is an amazingly fast time on the wet tyres.
Oh, and he's come off the track. He's totally come off the track. What? He can't be. Oh, he's fleeing.
Yep. Right. So Button's now half a second in front in provisional pole. He's pulled out. Oh, and now Kai's gone second fastest, just a tenth down on Button. It's all happened. The timing screens are changing literally by the second. So
I must admit, Button is really making sure he doesn't interfere in anybody's race. He's actually done that much. He's actually damaging his own bloody car. He wants to just trundle along people.
Well, the thing is, with Button, he's actually a very quick driver. He can be a bit inconsistent, depends if the mood takes him or not, but when he's on it, he's on it. And there's not many quicker.
Yeah.
So if he can put that together for an hour, he can win races, which I'm sure at some stage he will do.
Oh, flaming hell, that's the most dangerous way I've ever seen anybody coming in. Just get a move on, come into the pit, son. It's not as if you've got to save the tyres, it's with a wet set of tyres that can do a complete bloody race for them. Oh my god.
Well, of course, we're always on the lookout for potential hazards, people not getting out of the way. We've got a Force India's parked up around a Red
Honestly,
Bull.
Honestly, he doesn't need to come to the side of the road and stop. He just needs to go off the race line.
Who was that?
It's Button.
Oh, right, okay.
He's coming and stopping off the track. I know what he's doing, he doesn't want to interfere, but.
Sometimes it can be worse by not interfering. Someone's got a bit wide there at the hairpin. Oh, he's brushed the wall there. That's going to lose him some time.
All right. It's your dad is coming into the pits. Sim is on a lap, is he?
Fat Boy's just on an out lap at the moment, I think. Right, I'm on.
Sim is going to cross the line any second now. We'll keep on board with him, see what he does here. He's not. He's in the pits.
Right, have a look on Fat Boy. Fat Boy's just starting a hot lap.
Right, I'm going on Fat Boy. Where is he?
He's in the first sector.
There we go, got him. Yeah, I've got him. We're on board with him now, folks. This is Fat Boy. He made a hash of his first attempt. This is his second attempt. Currently 11th on the grid. I'm sure he's not going to be happy with that, somehow.
Right, his first sector time is actually not the quickest. It's about
25.6.
About the third. It's the fourth quickest. Fifth quickest.
He was quicker
so far
with his first attempt.
Yeah,
it's been faster than that.
The rain is easing off then. So the puddles are starting to clear a little bit, so I'm starting to wonder whether Inters might be coming on shortly. We've still got 7 minutes, and we're just under 8 minutes left in qualifying.
You think full wet might be just a bit overheating now? Maybe.
That's what I'm thinking. Right, second sector is in a 27.2, which is that's good. That's the second fastest.
Second fastest, he's there. Yeah. It's not that much pace off it then.
So it's all down to the last sector now to see where he's going to end up.
Wall of Champions. Oh, Wall of Champions. What's he going to do? Comes in. Oh, he comes into the pits. He's abandoned it. He's coming in for intermediate.
I think he's going to put the inters on. That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, I think that's the choice now. Like, it's dry enough for intermediates now. There's a dry line there appearing. Well, there's a line appearing, you know, like a grey, a darker grey. Oh, sorry, there's some people sweating in it. Was it James Slater? Very good stream, mate. Thank you, Mr. Slater. James Slater, raid. What? James Slater, you're about to get raided. Am I?
Well, anybody trying to raid our lobby, good luck with that, because it's locked down. You won't get in.
Yeah. Yeah. Go for it, son. Thank you for your input, James.
All cars on the western front at the moment on track. We've got seven cars out. Yeah, we've got some cars
at the moment.
Yeah, but we've got some cars out and into now, so it looks like it is ready to go.
Yeah, I'm going to go and get onto a car that's on the intermediate, and that happens to be Red Bull. Yes, we'll now have a look at Red Bull. Let's have a look. He's about to start a lap now. I'm around the first, second turn.
I'm just going for a very quick smoke, mate, if that's all right.
No problem, I've got it all in hand, son. Off you go. Turn around there. Let's take up the back bit. Let's see what he does around here. And his first time, 24, 25. Oh, yes, definitely quicker. 25.2. Well faster so far. Well faster than his own. Previous wet time, would have thought as well. Especially since it's definitely intermediate weather, that. Very good, coming up to the hairpin, got to get this right, it's hard to do and it's wet as well, just to get that, how much, and good exit, oh, we get the exit up there. Bit sound effects for you folks? No, it's so good. Anyways. Carrying on with the straights, so he's fourth quickest through the speed trap, and his time is a 1:24 provisional pole at the moment for Red Bull. The 1:24. Oh yeah, you seen it, guys. That's good. Right, who else is out there? Ben. Looks like he's starting a fast lap now. Let's get on board with It's Your Mum, also known to his friends as Ben. A 25.1 for his first sector time, so pretty quick. The intermediate seems to be working at the moment. Nice and smooth through there, good exit. And 26.6 for his second sector time. Let's have a quick look at that. 26.6. Yeah, it's pretty fast. Fastest at the moment, by the looks of it. All about this last sector. Can he get the wall of champions right? This is where it counts. It's a lovely turn in and looks smooth to me. I don't know about you folks. And crosses the line and goes into second place. 1:23.8. Well done. Nice one, Ben.
Okay.
Second place. Provisional second place.
Oh, nice time for Red Bull there on the inters.
Yeah. The intermediates are definitely the things to be on at the moment.
Let's have a look for...
I'm currently on board with Button, who's about to start his flying lap. He's about to come up to the start finish straight. We'll stay on board with...
Well, here comes Fat Boy coming in. This looks like a quick lap.
Yeah.
This does look like a quick lap. And that looks like it's going to be pole. Yeah, pole for Fat Boy at the moment. With the 1:22.4, he breaks into the 1:22s. Excellent lap there. In fact, he's a second in front at the moment. That's a big, big gap. Anybody?
Well, it's your dad. I want to find my prediction. Where is he? He's not even out on track. I am not happy. Where is my prediction? Oh, it's positively glad. We'll stay on board with positively glad because he's about to start his flying up. We'll stay on board with it glad. See what kind of time he puts in here. He could be the dark horse, you know, Mr. Glad.
Well, as I say, he's had back-to-back podiums. He's had a third place at Spain, a second place at Monaco.
He's knocking on the door for a...
Climb up that final ladder to get on the top of the podium. That's what he's going to be looking for. I've got no doubt about that. Mm-hmm. He's good enough as well. So, somebody sent me a message there. Venoms has gone to second, just 0.2 behind Fat Boy. So Venoms also getting those inters to work for him. Forrest has gone third in the whatever car he's driving. I'm not looking at the cars actually, to be honest, tonight.
A 24.8 for a first sector time from Glad.
Now, just a quick reminder.
Second sector time.
All the viewers, of course, the top 10, in fact, it's a wet qualifying, the cars can start on whatever tyres they like for the start of the race. Yeah,
26.7, that's
Hectic's gone third. The 123.1.
Yeah.
So he drops faster down to the fourth, and Red Bull drops down to the third row. And Paul's gone fourth quickest now, the 123.4, that puts Forster down to the third row of the grid. Good time there.
About to cross
Paul.
The line for positive. What's he going to do? He's currently 19th on the grid, so he definitely needs to get this time in. And it is a 123. It must have been invalidated.
It's invalidated. Yeah. Not on the timing screen. He's got time though. He's got time to put another one in.
Well, it's kind of fine.
Just to give you an idea, that would have put him in fourth place if that had been a genuine lap. So he's got some pace. There's no doubt about that.
What's your dad doing? He hasn't been out in intermediate.
Marley's gone third quickest with the 122.7, just 0.2 off Fatboy. Excellent lap there from Marley.
What? Oh, there we go.
Paul's on the wets at the moment. Is he actually on the inters now?
Yeah, he's on the inters. Yeah, I'm on board with him now. He's coming round. I don't think he's gone. Oh, this is 24.6.
Checkered flag's gone down. Oh. So, I can't see the time. The screen's now, unfortunately. I'm on board with Fatboy. Well, I'm just going to make a quick cup of tea before the race starts.
Oh, he's gone third. He's third on the grid. Well, folks, that was good. That was a good bit of qualifying. As soon as the time board comes up, we'll find out the actual final board, because obviously we can't see it right now. Board here, who's this we're on board with? Oh, Marley. Marley! A wee little Irishman. Hello there, Marley. Let's see, and he crosses the line, and I think he stays in fifth, yep. Hasn't improved his time.
Right, that's the cup of tea sorted. I'll be on the bog all night tonight.
Right, there's your lineup, boys and girls. Fat Boy's first on pole.
Okay, Fat Boy first, he went quicker. Visions went quicker than Fat Boy's previous lap, but he's got pace. Kai's in third. He snuck in there.
Yeah.
Venom's fourth. Marley fifth. Forrester sixth. Itchamum seventh. And Button eighth. Just a second covering the top eight. Then we've got Paul in ninth. Posglad 10. Red Bull 11. Sexy 12. Withy 13. Knitch 14. Simon 15. And Horndog 16th. And Calvano bringing up the grid in 17th
and
place.
And Swizz didn't go out?
No, so he will be starting behind us, so we'll have to be careful pulling over, I think, won't we, when they do start. And there we go, it's going to be a dry race tonight. Well, this is going to start dry. Always a chance it could rain. You know, it's never quite guaranteed at Canada, even though the weather forecast looks to set fair, with cloud increasing as the race goes on. There's always a chance of a shower, a sprinkle.
Oh, no, look at that sky. Look at that sky. Look at it. Blue. But, little puffy white clouds.
Fatboy's done just what he needs to do. He needs the qualifying pole because he needs to pull out that gap. Now, as long as he can avoid the first corner incidents, he'll be in the perfect place to set the pace and to stay out of trouble and hopefully, in terms of his race, pull out that gap he needs. Now, I think it's going to be a one-stopper tonight. Depending on what compound of tyre they start on, it might be a two-stopper for some of the guys starting on the ultras or the very, very soft tyre, whatever they're using tonight. I think it is the ultra soft, I think, Canada, isn't it?
Yeah. I would go for the personally. I would go for the two stop just because you don't really need to worry too much about tyre wear. You can absolutely hammer the car.
I think you have to run the orange. The yellow wall tyre at some stage. I believe the yellow wall, which is the soft tyre, is the prime tyre. Mm. So the option tyres, for want of a better word, are the ultra soft purple wall tyres and the red wall super softs. So I wonder if someone might go super soft, ultra soft, and then soft tyre. That might be the way to go. I don't know how many laps they can get out of those ultra softs at the start.
Yeah. Well, I could get... when I raced there, I could quite easily get to 20 laps on a set of ultras.
But you were losing pace,
and
though.
That was on 100%, though.
Yeah.
That wasn't on a 50%.
So that'd be 10 laps, in essence, on 50%. And you were losing a lot of pace there. Perhaps if you're going in, maybe lap 8, maybe to swap them over.
Yeah, lap 16, I think I should ideally came in on it instead of... Yeah.
Yeah. So the ultra soft runners, for those running on ultras, will be looking to come in. Will be looking for the first round of pit stops around about lap 8. I think for the super soft tyres, they'll be coming in around about 11 or 12. To give you an idea where we're at the moment, the drivers just prepping themselves at the moment. Last minute preparations, toilet break, cigarette break, coffee break, all the good stuff, and then you'll see them ready up. And then when they start, myself and Mustafashag will just peel off to the side of the track, retire our cars, and then we can jump on board.
It means we do miss the actual start. We need to figure out how to. We never did trial that. Yeah, we need to do that.
That's something we can do tomorrow, I think, can't we? We can have a bash at that and get a few people and just test it, because that would be a way forwards.
Yeah. So that then the viewers can get a full view looking down the track from the start.
Very impressive. Marley's qualified in fifth today. It's a very good spot for Marley. He's had a couple of poor races so far. Some of it's admittedly other cars causing damage to his car. He's qualified in a good position today, and he'll fancy his chances because he's a quick driver, Marley. I think he'll be fancy his chances of a podium tonight as long as he can keep out of trouble. I think it's going to be a cracking race. It should be one of the best races of the season. It really should be. So nice fast track, Canada. Quick laps as well. It's only 1 minute 15 lap times, 1 minute 14, even quicker towards the end. So lots of action. Some high speed corners, hairpin, of course, some nice long straights for overtaking, and of course the infamous Wall of Champions, which of course have seen many a driver over the years come a cropper.
I've clipped it many a time.
Sexy has left the session at the bottom there. I just noticed that's probably a bit of a lag issue there. Hopefully you can jump back in quite quickly.
Yeah. I think they'll probably just wait, but I think you've got to actually start and wait one lap before you can jump back into the car. So,
yeah, just turn.
Yeah, looks like we're off. We are. We're all go.
There we go. Yep. Sorry about that. So
I think
it's
locked to him. I think he can be the only one that can jump in to his seat.
It was invite friends only, to be fair. I have got Swizz behind me, so I'm going to move right straight away.
We're in anti-stall, clutch in, and build some revs.
And retire the car.
Gone by what I've seen ahead, when eventually does let me do
like it.
Right, there we go.
Come on, blimey. It's taking its time, isn't it? Yeah, Fat Boy's got the jump.
There we go.
This is what he wanted. He's already pulled out a second there already.
Hectic Vision's in second.
Yeah, he's got a good start there.
Red Bull's in third.
Is that Kai in the Sauber? In the Sauber, yeah. And we've got a Ferrari, which I think is... who's in that Ferrari? That's Marley. Marley's got a good start. No, Marley's in the red and the Renault, sorry.
Well, it looks like everybody got off. Like, I don't see any incidents. Everybody seems to be...
Everything looks good so far.
Okay.
Coming into the hairpin. Fat Boy nicely through there. He's already pulled out a good second already, so he's really putting a hammer down. He knows he needs to make a 20-second gap up straight away. So he's net minus 20 seconds at the moment. The Sauber's looking good there. Just going to jump on board the Sauber with Kai. He's making a move on Kai's making a move on Hectic, and he's made it stick. Great move there. And Venoms is now having a look at. Venoms is having a look also at Hectic there, side by side. I think Venoms is going to have the lead. Is he going to back off? What's happening here? And Venoms has got the move done. Oh, Hectic lost two places there in one quarter. And Marley, all over the back of Hectic, pulls out to the right. Is he going to make a move? Or is he going to back off? Let's have a look. He goes in. No, he backs off there. So, both Kai and Venoms got the jump. And that's exactly where Kai wanted to be, because he can just chase after
Hectic now.
That's exactly where he wanted to be.
There's somebody else in the background.
And Forrester. Forrester's making a move on Marley. The fifth place as they come in underneath the bridge. He's... Oh, it's side by side. Great driving. There was no incident there. Marley gave him the room, but still kept the foot down. But I think Forrester is going to get the job done going into the hairpin. Yep, Forrester has got the jump on Marley. So Forrester moves to fifth. Well, that was some good driving there from Marley and Forrester. Very, very clean, very fair. Side by side without any incident there. Marley's having a look again at Forrester up the inside. I think Forrester's going to hold the line that he does.
Yeah, Marley just nearly lost it there, I think. Go down the field, let's have a little look down the field.
Battle's
going on behind, yeah. Rutherly Man's about to be tacking Paul. Posse's right behind that pack as well. And you've got Sim behind them, and you've got...
We've got Sexy's back in.
Sexy's behind it.
Sexy's
back in.
That's good news.
Good, good. Right. At the moment, Rivy Man all over the back end of Paul here, but he's got a big train right behind him.
And they've got Calvano.
It's your mum's fighting.
Yeah, Calvano's pressurising Horn Dog for the final two places there. He really is. He's having. Horn Dog's just a bit off the pace at the moment. He's normally very good, actually.
Here comes Rivy Man to make a move. He's going to try the inside here, and. Oh, he didn't make it. Unlucky.
Just have a look at that battle. Oh, yeah, but. He's Posse's now going up with him, man, on the outside, going into the hairpin. I think Posse's done it under braking. Yeah. He's done it under braking. Great move by Posse.
Oh, so he's been... got as well.
Yeah, and Sim's done it as well. With him went a bit deep there. Went a bit deep, he's Sim lost two places. He's got DRS on Simon now, so expect him to make the pop. But Simon himself has got DRS on Posse. So I don't think there's going to be an overtake here. It's going to be very, very risky. No, with him backs out, he just puts the brakes on. Oh, but he's got a good drive out of there. On Simon, I think with your man might be making a move on Simon. This is for the final points place.
Willie Man's gone for the inside, moving to the turn one.
Turn one. I think he's going to have it. He's gone a bit deep.
He's made it. Oh, no, he's coming back.
Simon's
he's
coming
the
back in. But I think Withy's covered him off there.
He's held it. Yeah, that was a good move there. Sexy sitting there waiting to pick up the pieces by the looks of
things. That's right, he was.
Koenig is behind that as well.
Oh, Koenig,
and there's somebody else behind that.
Well, Koenig should be looking, poor start for him, he'll be looking to get up the order here, because he's a good driver. He's already had second place this season already. Right, let's jump back on front. I want to see how Fatboy's getting on. Going into the hairpin.
Yeah,
the
keep gap. An eye on this, because there's some battle going on here.
Yeah.
Venoms
is pressurising Kai. Kai's 2.5 seconds down on Fatboy at the moment, just to give you an idea of what we're looking at. So far, so good.
Oh, here we go. Big Sexy's going to be looking to have a little go here. Oh, the free car fight for the WOR champions. Oh, it looks like there's a yellow banana car there, went out of shape.
Is that Marley, was it? Further back. Forrester, by the way, has actually opted for the soft tyre. He's on a different strategy. He's gone for the slower tyre first. He obviously wants to be on the quickest possible tyre at the end. Now, I'm sure, can't you run ultra softs around the ultra soft purple wall tyre around here? Because I can't see anybody on it.
Havano's there, and 16.
Just looking at Paul's on the soft tyre on the yellow compact. Well, this is the prime tyre, so that's going to sit well for Paul later on in the race. He can put some softer tyres on.
Can I just ask a question? Why is Button so far back?
Aye. don't know.
He's
little
in
look
17th
where he's...
place.
Oh, he's had a... He must have had an instant summer. Let me check the race directory.
Yeah, it's way, way down the field. Miles from anybody.
Swiss picked up a drive-through.
Has it? Oh, must have been a jump start.
No, he actually he had an incident with Knitsch. This was the reason why Knitsch dropped down the grid. And then when Swiss went to pit for wing damage, he picked up a drive-through.
On board here with Kai and Vemmens here. Kai and Vemmens having a good battle here for second and third.
Couple of penalties already, nothing too untoward. There's nothing about Button that I can see at the moment.
No. I just don't understand why he's...
Yeah, such a... Was he perhaps not ready or something, or...?
No, no idea, but he's well down the field, like 17th place.
Yeah, that is strange,
though,
isn't it?
Not where I thought Button would be.
Venoms has got into second place. Venoms has passed Kai.
Yeah, so I'm seeing his Vemmens and his Kai. That's the battle I've been on.
Now, the thing is, though, they can actually help each other out a bit here because they can use each other's DRSs to try and... I mean, the gap's coming down. It's 2.6 seconds between Fatboy and Venom. So Fatboy's not exactly...
DRS open.
Yeah. Fatboy's not exactly running away with it yet. He is, you know, he's got a gap there, but it's obviously nowhere near as big as he needs it to be at the moment. There's Kai in third, and Hectic's just starting to lose touch a little bit with these two now in fourth. And Forrester's in a good position, Skin. He's 9 seconds down the leader, but he is on the soft tyre. He's on the hard, on the prime tyre.
The harder.
So he'll be quicker at the end of the race. He'll be one to watch later on in the race. Itchamun's moved into sixth place now. He's past Marley. Marley's dropped to seventh, and we've got Paul, I think, in eighth. And Paul's also having a good race. Paul also on the prime tyre. He's catching the cars in front of him. He's catching Marley and he's catching Mum. Paul's is a couple of seconds down. He's also on the soft tyre, so he'll be again putting on the quicker tyre towards the end of the race, in the second half of the race. And Simon is the final point scorer, but he's in a right battle with Sexy at the moment. They're side by side. They've also got the Force India behind him, which I think that's Red Bull. So there's a three-way battle here for the final points slot. All to play for here. As they come into the hairpin. Oh no, not good, and not good at all. Simon's gone deep into it, and Sexy's going to get the jump here. He's going to get DRS. In fact, Simon's not careful. He could lose two positions here because Red Bull's going to have DRS as well. Now they come into the Wall of Champions. Three cars, nose to tail. And they
there we go.
Simon got a good exit. Simon got, but Sexy's got DRS, so.
Red Bull's going to think of it as well.
Yeah, he might get the move. It's close. Oh no, Sexy blocks him off there with the legitimate defensive driving, just covering off the apex there, covering the car off behind him, which is allowed.
Because Red Bull's sitting there waiting to go.
Red Bull, yeah, well, that's it, you see, that is it. It's all happening here. So I'd imagine first pit stops would be around about lap 12 for the super soft runners, I'd imagine. Maybe even a bit further. They might be get to 15, actually. Doesn't look like there's any runners on the ultra soft tyre at the moment at all. Which does surprise me. And in fact, there was Red Bull there having a look at Simon. It backs off, fighting it out for 11th and 12th place. Sexy's managed to get a bit of breathing space. In fact, I think Sexy might have got himself out of DRS range with these two cars. Oh, we got a car that's gone
who's
very slow
path?
Now. Who's that? Swiss. Swiss is out of the race. Swiss is out of the race. But that was another car. That looked like a Sauber. Oh, not a Sauber, sorry. Yeah, Toro Rosso now. Let me have a look here.
Yeah. We lost two drivers.
Kai's still there in third. Now, where's Itchamun? I think it's Itchamun, you know. It's Itchamun. He's had an instant,
it's
your mum's dropped down to 14th place. He's had an instant there. We'll check the race directory.
Oh.
He was actually running in 6th place at that time. So let's have a little look.
Yeah, that's it. Who was it? Swiss. It was the one that was parked up.
Yeah, Swiss. Well, no, the car that was parked up at the hairpin was a Sauber on my screen. Sorry, a Sauber. He's left the session now as well. It was a Toro Rosso. Right, Swiss has left the session. Okay. Too sure what's happened there.
Didn't catch it wherever it was at the top, and we've missed it somewhere.
Oh! Yeah, his car's out. His car is out. He's, his car, I think he's written his car off. Right, let's have a look at Fat Boy. And Fat Boy has been caught. Burnham's has caught him, and so's Kai. Well. He has been caught. But now, Fat Boy. Now, Fat Boy's on the Ultras. Fat Boy's the one guy who did go on the Ultras. Now, the Ultras are wearing off now. He had that initial pace, and that initial burst of pace, and now those tyres are dying. He's done 10 laps.
The super softs will have another five laps worth of.
Yeah, he needs to pit. Those tyres are going to be absolutely dead now. The super softs will still probably have three or four, maybe five laps left in them. So it'd be interesting to see if Fat Boy does indeed pit at the end, because Venoms is going to have DRS on him here anyway. And of course, the way the pit lane's structured at Canada, it's a bit of a hazard, isn't it? Because it's a flat-out drive almost right up to the pit lane.
Oh, he's going to have a go here, though.
Fat Boy's gone defensive on the inside. And Venoms, I think, is going to be through that. Yeah, Venoms is through now. Is Fat Boy going to pit? What's Fat Boy doing? No, Fat Boy staying out?
Nope. He's pushing his luck, right?
Oh, Venom's there. Grassed his right front there. There's quite a gap. These three have pulled out quite a gap now over fourth place. Hectic is 6 seconds down, but Hectic himself is clear in fourth place. Forrester's in fifth, and Forrester's again, and Venom are 5 seconds down. And Forrester's got Marley now all over the back of him. I wonder if Forrester's had a bit of a scrappy lap somewhere. Now, Kai is all over the back of Fat Boy. Venom's just starting to pull away from Fat Boy now, I've noticed. He's definitely pulling out some car lengths there. These ultra softs on Fat Boy's car now starting to really suffer.
Oh, it's second.
They're really starting to suffer now. He's gone defensive there against Kai. Kai has a look at the inside going into the hairpin. I think he's going to do it. He's going to have DRS. He's going to have DRS. Oh, Kai, big wobble from Kai there. Big wobble there.
Getting the power back on.
Big fish tail.
Of course,
tail
Kai doesn't use any assist though, does he?
Yeah, he's got it now. Yeah, and he goes on the outside. Fat Boy's giving him all the room he needs, which is good driving. Good to see, of course. Excellent driver awareness and etiquette there. But I think Kai and Fat Boy's
pitting.
He's
in the pits. He's in the pits.
Now, I'm going to stay on board because I think if you put him, putting the soft tyres on, the yellow wall tyre. Let's have a little look. If he doesn't, then he's going to have to two-stop it. I can't think he'll risk a two-stop knowing he's got to make 20 seconds. It's yellows, right, so he's doing a one-stopper. Now, where's Fat Boy going to come out then? He's going to come out to... actually, in some rare... He's coming out in traffic. I thought he was going to come out clean air, but he's not. No, he's not.
It means he's still going to have to do 23 laps on them tyres. That's quite a big asking for a set of softs even.
Now he's up behind Paul. Paul lets him through. Oh dear, why'd you let him through, Paul? He's not your teammate. Paul obviously not wanting to interfere in that battle at all. He's decided to get out of the way, let Fat Boy through, let him do his thing, which is, I suppose, that's very generous and kind.
Who's that? Ah, Raratron. Hi, Shaggy. Hi, Raratron. I see your message here. How you doing, kiddo?
Fat Boy's come out in... he came out in seventh, but he's managed to get a jump on Paul there. Now he's coming up behind Marley and Forrester. Give you an idea.
Yeah.
Now the car's in front. Oh, look at that. Venoms and Kai neck and neck. Kai's making the move on Venoms. Is he under DRS coming to turn one? No! Venoms covered him off. Oh, that was a great little... Great little bit of defensive driving there from Venoms. Kai's right up the old exhaust pipe here. As they come through the S's in... they come up to the S's in the first sector. Now, if you can get a good exit here, there's a possible overtake here.
You can get the power, he's all over first. This gearbox here.
Yeah, Venoms, though, putting the car in the centre of the track. Yeah, but Venoms there, good defensive. He's put the car right under the track. Beer and kebab style.
You get the feeling if Kai gets in front, he's going to be away though. He's got more grip.
I just want to see how long these two can stay on these tyres and how much, whether they can lap quicker now on these tyres than Fat Boy will and on the sauce. Otherwise, Fatboy's going to jump them both, and they'll both have to pass him. If you see what I mean, because obviously Fatboy's made that pit stop. He's gone for the early, well, the earlier stop compared to these two cars. Right, here comes Kai in the slipstream. Pulls out to the right.
Here they go.
Under braking into the wall of champions. I think he's going to get this done. Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
But Vedums gets a good exit, but Kai's got DRS. Kai's defensive to the left. I think Kai's going to be here under braking to turn one. Closes the door, hits the apex. Textbook cover driving there from Kai.
I get the feeling Vemmings' tyres are shot.
Well, they'll be wearing now, that's for sure. The Super Softs will be wearing. Of course, they don't wear as quickly as the Ultra Softs, obviously. Kai is already, look at Kai, he's pulled out half a car length already. This is important for Kai. Kai almost lost it. There, he put the power down. The back end just fishtailed out and brushed the grass.
I wonder if he took damage there.
That was so close, Skin. That was so close to losing his car.
I wonder if he's got wing damage there, because he definitely gave the wall a good call out.
Let him jump on his car. Well, not literally jump on his car, because that might slow him down a bit.
Have a little scout around his car. I can't see initially any damage.
No, front end looks fine. Back end looks okay. I think he's okay. I think what it was the actual left, the right rear wheel. Vedums is in the pits. Vedums is pitting. It was his right rear on the grass. It threw up a load of dirt. Now, I'm going to jump on board of Vedums because I want to see if Fatboy's got the jump on him in the pits. He puts the yellow tyres on, so he'll be going to the end of the race.
With the undercut, be ahead of him.
It all depends what pace Fatboy got out of those harder tyres. I think he has. I think he's got to, that is Fatboy's car, I think, just going through there. Let's have a little look. Has he? I'm not convinced. Let's have a look at Fatboy. Did Fatboy get the jump? Yes, Fatboy did get the jump. He put in a couple of really quick laps there.
Forrester's got in front of him as well. We've got Forrester between them two as well.
Now, Forrester won't be pitting for a while yet because he's on the soft tyres. He'll be probably looking to take these to lap 20.
Different strategy.
Yeah.
So that's going to hold Vemmings up a little bit.
Vemmings needs to, he's going to have to pass him pretty damn promptly. Because Fatboy's pulled out about a 7 second undercut. Of course, the question is how well can Fatboy now look after his tyres and knowing he has to push at the same time because he's got to make a 20 second gap? That's the question. Vedums will be on newer tyres. I mean, at the moment, Fatboy's tyres in perfect condition, but they might wear a little bit more towards the end of the race because he did pit those few laps earlier.
There's a car in the pits there.
I think was that Forrester in the pits? If it was, Now Forrester's pitted early. That's an early pit stop for Forrester. Those softs, he has not made the softs last. He's putting on the super sauce, which means that he's going to have to two stop it. He's not going to get these super softs to the end. So that looks like it's going to be our first two stop strategy. Now, he's going to be battling Paul because Paul also started on the soft tyre, as did Posglad. So I think Forrester could be battling these two.
And Vemmings did get in front of Kai in the pit stops.
And they're battling again now. This, of course, Fatboy's going to be thinking, I hope these two crash. I really hope these two crash. But in fact, they're both. I think that's Fatboy in front of these two. That he hasn't. No, he's not that far in front. To be fair, not as far as I thought. He is about. He's about 2 seconds.
It's your mum. It's your dad. That means about to make a move.
Yeah, he's on the outside. Vedums has gone defensive on the inside. They are literally side by side. I think he's got the move done. The DRS under braking. How's the exit?
Move done.
Exit's fine. Kai gets to jump into second place.
Nice. So, my prediction might not be finished yet, son.
We're looking good so far. One of our drivers is going to win this race, but it's one of our predictions.
Yeah.
Now, is Vedums going to put a...
Your other prediction of Vemmings was going to be up there as well.
Well, yeah.
He's up there.
It's got to be Mystic.
The only one I feel like is not there is Forrester. Where is Forrester?
Now, he's pitted, but he went on to the Super Softs. He came out in ninth place, but I think he's going to have to stop again, Skinny. I don't think he's going to make the Softs because he came in on lap 15 to put the Red Bull tyre on. I'd be very surprised if he makes those last 20 laps, considering he's only got 15 laps out of the Softs. He's got to make a Kai there, again, picking up some dirt. Now, Venom's just going to have the run on him here with DRS. Kai will come out the hairpin ahead, but I'm sure Venom's will have him on DRS. Now, this could be a tactic to try and haul the Fat Boy back in, using each other's DRS lap after lap. It gains him an extra half a second, you know. Here comes. I don't. Look at that. He just breezes past him there.
Sail past him, yeah.
One thing about the Toro Rosso is, of course, it's not quick in a straight line. That's the. It's good for the corners, but it's not got the grunt, which is surprising considering it's got the Ferrari engine.
It's a bit like the Red Bull.
Yeah, it's got the Ferrari engine, though, isn't it? You'd think it's. That power unit.
You think it'd have the power.
Yeah, but it doesn't.
It doesn't. No, I agree.
It's a strange one.
There's no top end in it.
Right. I'm going to have a quick flick through. Now, Paul is now in fourth place, but he's got Forrester. No, he's got Hectic all over the back of him. Hectic, of course, has pitted. Or has he? Yes. Hectic has pitted, and I think Hectic makes the move. Or has he?
Ah.
They come into the chicane. And, Paul yields nicely. Good driving, Paul. Good awareness. He's got Posglad right behind him. Now, Paul hasn't pitted yet.
Fat boy. They're definitely really up. Yeah. Proper catching him.
Now, Hectic's pitted. He's in fourth place. Paul hasn't pitted. He's in fifth. And Poz is right behind him. Yeah. Also, Poz is yet to pit. Those two will be going on to the Super Soft or the Ultra Softs in around about two or three laps' time, I think. Look for the pit stops. And Marley is just behind them. Also on the soft tyre. See, these three have managed to get their tyres to last better than Forrester did this particular race. Oh, look at this. Marley's all over the back of Posglad. That was tight. Good driving. Really drafting in there. Oh, got a message from the
board. It's a hell of a battle up here for third.
It's the start. How was it? Rara. Good start. Some very good driving, actually. I think Swizz had a little coming together with Knitsch. That was about it. And unfortunately, Swizz, when he pitted, picked up a drive-through for exceeding speed limits in the pits. And that was that. But apart from that, it was all good, Rara. It was a very good start indeed.
Yeah, very good start. Very, very good start.
Now, Hectic is really pushing now. Hectic is net fourth at the moment. Poz, there's a good battle here. I don't know if you want to come on it. It's between Paul and Poz. And they're both on the soft tyres on the prime tyre. Silly camera angle at the moment, which I don't want. Now, here comes...
Board here, and... keep it together.
Poz has got DRS here, but he should be really just sat behind drafting Paul, because he's not getting the most out of his DRS by moving out, if you know what I mean. He needs to...
In
fact, Paul's pitting. Paul's had enough of these soft tyres. Let's see what compound. I imagine he's going to put the super softs on, so he might just be able to get to the end on those now. I was still thinking a little bit early. Yeah, he's putting the super softs on, so he needs to get... He's got
Fat Boy is under a lot of pressure here.
Okay. Oh, I'm going to jump on that.
He's got Dad all over his back end here.
Because Kai's pull away from Venom.
They've left Venom behind.
Yeah, Venom's is about a second and a half down the road, so here we go. And this is for position as well. This isn't just for track position, this is for position.
This is for the lead.
But in fact, to give you an idea, Skinny, let me just get some stats up real quick. Looking at the pit stop situation. In fact, at the moment, believe it or not, Fatboy is only in net fourth place with that penalty. He's fourth at the moment if you put that penalty on and looking at the pit stops. So at the moment...
We've changed leaders.
It's Shaddad. We've got a new race leader there. As Shaddad makes a move there, but Fatboy drafting him. That's good driving. Good driving there, but Fatboy's going to get a good drive out of
here. Come up the inside again.
Yeah, he's going to pressurise him all the way into the corner. No, I think Kai's going to hold him off. Good driving there. Now, You see how the now Fat was going to get up the inside. Look at this, going. Oh, that's he's done it as well. What a great overtake! And he's going to that's going to stick as well. That was a great overtake.
Yeah, he's done it.
Right, I'm going to record that.
Dad, just give him a little tap at the back end.
Yeah, I've just recorded that skin because that was a quality overtake. It's not really a place you'd expect an overtake to be done. Actually, going into the corner before you even get to the corner. Got such a good drive out of the left hander.
Oh, proper locking his wheels up this Kai. Oh, and he's obviously running. That's given Vermin a chance to catch
Kai's
up
got DRS here. Kai can just he won't pass that boy right here, but he's got the DRS just to allow him to pull up
for the second bit.
A few car lengths. There we go. He'll get another stab of DRS here as well, just to close up into the back. This is where you can see that Fatboy, he does drive with assist, but he's a master of driving with assist. Very smooth driver. As you see the difference where Kai is running without assist, which means his car is naturally harder to control for anybody who's new to the game.
Yeah.
So you've got two completely contrasting styles of driving.
Oh.
But Kai's now again, let's see, he's all over the back of Fatboy. Because Kai means he can break that little, running ABS and running auto gears, running manual gears and no traction.
Here we go.
He can break that little bit later.
Move.
He just needs to take it easy. No time. Of course, and Venoms has now caught them back up again. It's back to a three-way dance
he's all
again
over
now.
The back end.
In fact, now, both Kai and Venoms will have DRS now. So Fatboy needs to defend really
and
well.
And Venoms will get a double DRS.
Yeah, so let's have a look. Fatboy goes to the inside. So Fatboy's picked his line. He's in the centre of the track. He can't really move. Yeah, oh, that's fair enough. He just moves to the left a bit, but he wasn't to break. Here we go. Oh, great overtake there. But, contact.
Oh. And it took Venoms as well with him.
I'm going to record that.
Did you get that?
I did, but not a great view, to be fair. I was on board Kai's car looking forwards, but I saw I saw Fatboy's... we'll talk about it later anyway. It did look a bit like a racing incident, to be fair. Two cars fighting for the same bit of track, but we'll have a look at that one later. We'll see what happens now. What's happened to Venoms and Fatboy now? They're still going. They managed to keep going, but they have obviously lost a lot of time. They're now 8 seconds behind the leader.
Doesn't look like any of them are carrying any damage.
No, Venom's car looks okay. I'm just going to check Fatboy's car. That looks okay. So, can't see any obvious damage. The end plates look to be there on Fatboy's car. Yeah, and on Venom's as well. So, thankfully, there was no damage done. Which is no one's race has been ruined as such, which is good to see. Now, has that allowed Hectic to... Yeah, Hectic's now... of course, that has allowed Hectic to move within 5 seconds of the leaders, as you can see. If you look back from Venom's car there, look back from Venom's, you'll see Hectic's car in the background.
I'm on board with Hectic.
Down the straight. He's definitely catching. Obviously he caught them by quite a few seconds with that.
There's a little battle here. What is this between Positively Glad and Forrester having a bit of a battle here?
Now, of course, Forrester let's have a quick tyre. Poz, I don't think Poz has pitted yet. He is still on his original tyres. He must have pitted, surely. Yeah, he must have pitted. But he's actually going for a two-stopper then, because he started on the soft. So these two are actually battling for position, but they're on different tyre strategies. But they're both two-stopping by the looks of it. Well, Poz definitely has to stop again, because he has not run another tyre. He's done both stints on the softs.
He's going to come back in and probably be the last sort of 7 or 8 laps on the set of ultra softs.
Ultra softs, yeah. And I think Forrester will probably do the same as well, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Right. Skin. Yeah. Sorry, Skin. I'm going to have to go use the toilet. I have a very quick cigarette, mate.
No problem. I'm just going to have a little flick down the field, see where everything is.
Okay, mate. And when I come when I come back, I'll have a look at the penalties and keep you abreast of that.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, there's a little battle here. It's your mum and Marley having a little battle. Stay on board with us at the moment, see where this is going. Oh, Ben keeping the nice defensive line up there. Oh, but he's got Marley both on the same tyres. Don't know who pitted when. Yeah, Mario's got a bit more grip at the moment. Oh, he's going to have DRS as well. There we go, makes a move. And the DRS quite easily makes the pass. And that promotes Marley into 10th place, last point in the championship. The race today, so. Oh, Ben, it's your mum's leader, is it called? Oh, who's that in the background? Who is that? Oh. Red Bull's had a problem. Oh, Red Bull is all over this. Is Red Bull getting damaged? Oh, I think Red Bull's got some damage. Is he? I can't see any. Oh, it looks intact, like. Oh, look at this for a battle here. Everybody wants that last point. I don't know if Ben's car is carrying a problem or something, because it seems to be dropping a place.
Right, I'm still under the pause. He's actually pitted and put the ultra softs on, which is what I expected. But he's going to have to go quite some way to make these tyres last, actually.
Yeah, like I said, I would imagine about 10 laps in that absolute. So if you'll get the 10 laps, you'll get 9 laps out of them, I would have thought, straight away. But they're going to be gay ragged.
Yeah, car very is,
well, I'm watching now. I don't know what's happened to Ben, car. He's carrying a problem. But we're on board here with Red Bull, who's making a move.
Fat boy's pitting.
And he's past Marley.
Fat boy is pitting. That does surprise me. Yeah. I thought he was going to do a one stopper.
Oh, there's a four way battle here from 9th to 12th.
And Fat boy's got a stop go penalty. Oh dear, it's not gone well there. He's got a stop go.
Oh, Fat boy has.
Yeah,
and he's got 20 seconds, don't forget.
And he's been jumped by a Ferrari, which I think could well be Venom's now. Indeed, it is. Venom's has got the jump. Venom's has got the jump on Fatboy there.
Red Bull nearly lost it into the wall of champions.
Which means that Hetrick is now in second place and Paul is now in third place. And Paul might not be stopping again. He's got the super softs on. Paul might not be stopping. This could be net third for Paul. Oh, in which case, that's a great strategy call. But you see, he's got Venoms. Looking back from Paul's car in third, he's got Venoms and Fatboy. He will be catching him now, no doubt. We've got 8 laps to go. They have about 3.5 seconds to gain by the looks of it. It is about 3 seconds. Now, Kai, mind you, is coming up to a car to lap. That looks like it's going to be Calvano. I just checked. It looks like Calvano. Looking back from Calvano's car. Is that Calvano? No, it's not Calvano's car. Who's in the other cell? Is that the cell?
What's wrong with Ben's car? It's your mum, but he seems to be getting past so easy. He's dropping places left, right, and
No, he might be having problem. If he's on the wheel, it's possible he might be having a problem with his gears again. Remember, he had that problem before he couldn't get out. He was stuck in 8th gear.
Oh, I don't know what happened there. I think he's a gun.
No, Withy Man's being blue flagged, and he sensibly just moved. Good driving, Withy Man. Well done. Good awareness there. Obeyed the blue flag to let Kai, the race leader, through.
Yeah, he's in the pit, and a set of ultra softs have gone onto Ben's car.
Kai is 13 seconds in front of Hetrick. Paul is a further 13 seconds. Now, here we go, third, fourth, and fifth. We jump on this one, Skinny. We've got Paul, and we've got Venoms and Fatboy on the ultra softs. Right on his tyre.
I'm on board.
This is fourth position. Venoms going up the inside. Under heavy under braking. Paul's got a good drive out of there. Venoms will have DRS, as will Fatboy. Now, What will Paul do? Well, he's gone to the inside. He's gone defence for the inside. Fat boy. He's at the meat in a sandwich at the moment. Fat boy here might have got the move made on Benham's. Oh, that was so close. Great driving to avoid any contact there. Good awareness by both cars. Wow, that was close. In fact, I'm going to record that because that was a great bit of driving. That was a quality bit of driving from all three guys there. Paul was looking to try and defend both sides as best he could and tried his best, but also showed good awareness by knowing where those two cars were. Also good driving from Fatboy and Benham's for going, again, they went into the corner at the same time. Fatboy's right at his exhaust pipe. My goodness me, that's so close. Look at that. A battle between third and fourth.
Yeah, I'm on board.
Wow.
Fatboy now.
These two really are. They've been tussling all race.
No.
Now, Fatboy will have the DRS, of course. But of course, we know that Ferrari does have some good straight line speed. But I know Fatboy's running a 5.5 wing. He runs quite a low downforce around this track because I noticed I pitched his setup. But you see, the Ferrari's got some straight line speed there. Fatboy can't make the move there. Is he coming to the world champions now? What kind of drive can Fatboy get? He's got the toe. He's got the DRS
he's got
open.
He's going to make it move.
He's going to have it into the corner, I think. Yeah, Venoms goes wide. And just Fatboy slots through there. Textbook overtake. Good driving there from both cars. Paul, just hanging on the background there, Paul. He's interested just to see if these two, take each other out or something. You know what I mean? Right,
yeah, I bet.
Penalties. Let's have a quick little shift in. Let's see what we can see on the board. There's Marley. Tuffy. Apple. Apple. Again. Button's got a penalty. Withy again. Adams has got a 3-second penalty. Ross has got a 3-second penalty. Paul's got a 3-second
penalty. Batman might be able to get Fatboy back here along the start finish straight. He's all over the gearbox. And he's got a DRS here. Yep, he's going to make a move here. Comes up. Oh.
Bulldog got a drive through. Withy's going to be close to a DQ, I think. He's in the directory a lot at the moment. That boy's picked up 3 penalties so far, so having the best places, to be fair. Benham's has got and 1. Kai's clean, I think, at the moment. But I tell a lie, he's got 1 3-second penalty. Yeah, it's just jumping back on. We've got 4 laps to go.
It's your dad is still ahead on first place. Looks like he's going to go to the end.
Now, is that a lapped car in front of these
second.
Two? Yes, it is. It's the second Haas car.
Here, Vehmens has still got Fatboy all over his back end trying to get past here.
Yeah, they've got a slower car in front of them at the moment. It's a second Haas. I think that's Horn Dog's car?
Horn Dog, it's Horn Dog.
Hopefully he'll just get out of the way and let these two go. He's being blue flagged now. I think he might wait until just after the Wall of Champions. Just far enough in front, but I think he'll have to pull over before turn one. These two, of course, are. Yeah, good driving, Horn Dog, well done. See that nicely out of the way. I'm going to record that as an example.
That's how you do it,
how to get out of the way safely and in a good position. Well done, Horn Dog. Now, Kai, by the way, is absolutely mulled it in distance. He's 23 seconds up the road now, so unless Kai has
gone.
A disaster, he's got his first win. I hope that's not the commentator's curse.
Was right.
Oh, that was so close by Fatboy there. He is so close, he's hounding Venoms.
Oh, he's probably giving him a hard time here. Like.
But Venoms is not buckling under the pressure. Of course, Fatboy will have DRS, but we've seen that Ferrari has got some serious grunt in a straight line on the last lap.
Forrester is getting pressured by Positive Glad, who's right up his backside as well. So there's quite a few battles up and down the track at the moment.
I'm just on board with Venoms and Fatboy, because Fatboy will have DRS, but I don't think that Hass can really make an impression on that, even with what? The DRS. Let's have a look again. Right. Fatboy goes out and have a look. He hasn't got it. He has not got the straight line pace to pass Venoms, even with DRS. Horn dog getting out
the way again. Good stuff.
Now, can he get a better exit out of here? Does he come down the start finish straight up to turn one? No, Venoms has covered him off again. This is great driving by Venoms, but the horsepower at Ferrari, it's so quick in a straight line.
Well, who's coming in the pits? Red Bull's in the pits.
Red Bull's in the pits. Nice. Is it a drive-through penalty you're serving or a pit stop?
I have no idea. I've come off into anywhere else. No,
I'll tell you what, you stick on these, I'll find out.
No, it's tyre change.
Tyre change, ultrasofts. And then you, slightly unusual. Yeah, I think he's messed up his strategy a little bit there, hasn't he? By pitting so late, which has allowed a couple of cars to get the jump on him there. Back to the battle between third and fourth. Now, Fatboy's closer than he's been before. He is now drafting Venoms. Now, can he make the pass? Venoms goes left. Fatboy goes further left now. Is it coming? I think Fatboy's got the move done this time.
Yeah, he's got it.
Fatboy's through the champions. Can he? Now, the Ferrari there, quick in a straight line again. Venoms is drafting him, but I think Fatboy is... Yeah, he's clear now. He's got
his DRS open, so...
As we're on our penultimate lap. And Kai Pollitt there, it's your dad, just serenely driving on now on his penultimate lap. Coming through sector two, up towards little chicane there, and then up the straight up towards the hairpin. He's drove an absolutely exemplary race so far. Slight lock up there as he comes around the hairpin. Safely out of there, foot down the accelerator, going up for the gears. As he comes down the long straight, winding up towards the World Champions, and then he'll be starting his final lap. This has gone so quickly, this race, hasn't it?
With Forrester and
it's really flown by.
Guys wanting to make a move here.
Well, there's Kai.
So close.
Safety for the World Champions. Right, Kai's just literally just starting his last lap.
Yeah. We're coming around the hairpin at the bottom. I think he's definitely close enough to have a go here, possibly glad if we're going to have a go here. Sexy's in the background there, I could just see his name in eighth place. DRS open, Forrester goes defensive, goes to the inside.
I think Forrester is going to hold in here, is he? This is going to be tight.
No, he's in front. No, he's got
he's caught a cut. He's caught a cut.
He's
lost it. And that's going to allow Marley to close right up now. Can Marley pinch position here? Is that Sexy or Marley? I think it's Marley, isn't it?
Sexy.
Where's Marley? Because he was doing well earlier on.
Sexy's now all over the back end of Glad. Anyway, I better get back to the leader.
And Simon's been disqualified there. I think that's for multiple warnings. It's a shame he would have been starting his last lap. That's a real shame.
It's your dad. Fantastic race. My prediction.
Yeah,
he's going to win the Canadian.
Hey, look, he's showboating a bit there. He was showboating, did you see that?
Just a little wiggle.
Showboating for the camera. Needs to be careful. Doesn't want to lose it there. Put it to the wall.
Don't be doing it too much,
son. don't. As he comes to the Wall of Champions, safely through. There he goes. And that's our race winner. It's your dad.
Well done, Kai.
Well done. Great drive. Deserved winner.
Now,
I think Fatboy's going to finish in second place, but of course the problem he... Hectic will finish in second. Here comes Hectic. Yep, well done, Hectic,
well done,
second
Hectic.
Place. Fatboy comes through third in position ahead of Venoms. Of course, he does have a 20-second penalty to add on.
So
now,
that will happen.
He's going to lose fourth place to Paul. He's going to possibly lose fifth and sixth place, and maybe even seventh place here. Oh, Sexy got all out of shape there. And I think Forrester's done. Forrester's run out of fuel. Forrester ran out of fuel, I think. Oh, he's been hit by Sexy. Past the finishing line. We'll record that for fun. that was most amusing.
Yep. Very good, fantastic racing.
Yeah.
Couldn't keep up all the action.
That was great. I think Forrester ran out of fuel and Sexy ploughed straight into him just after they passed the finish. There's Knitsch coming in 11th. Marley finished 10th, by the way, so Knitsch in 11th. In fact, no, I think Knitsch has taken 10th on penalties.
Fantastic racing etiquette in that race.
That was awesome to watch.
That was excellent to watch. Now, take a quick screenshot of that.
Take a screenshot, because we need that.
I need to take two screenshots, actually, because I need to get the timings.
Yeah, the penalties as well. Yeah. Hang on. The timings is what you need. Because you've got 20 seconds to add on. And we'll get there.
I think, actually, believe it or not, Fatboy's actually finished way down in 8th or 9th place. The podium finishers are It's Your Dad, Hectic, and Pure Venoms.
And Fatboy finished 4th anyway, so by the time he had the time on.
I think with the time on, I think he's going to come about 9th in the end, but I have taken a screenshot.
So we need to get Dad, Vision, and Venoms in. Right. Yep. Do you want to invite them in for me, mate? Because I'll pause the broadcast.
Just going to bring the drivers in now, viewers. That's got a fine car. He's actually showing us offline at the moment, so just send him a message.
Yeah. Pure Vermin joins the party. So we just need Dad, and then that's us.
I just sent the invite out. And here comes It's Your Dad. Right, chaps, if you can include your audios, please, we'll be grateful.
Make sure all your audio is included, please. And then we can begin. Okay, viewers, welcome to the three top podium finishers. Fantastic racing by all three. Fantastic racing etiquette all round. And to prove on top of it, I've got to say a big thank you to my big buddy Kai here. It's Your Dad for proving this commentator right in his prediction that he was going to win the Canadian Grand Prix. Fantastic job, son. Well done. And from your point of view, how do you think your race went, Kai?
Told you not to do that, Shaggy, you cunt.
how did it feel to cross that line in first place?
Felt good, man.
Yeah. You had some good old battles there, but you were, honestly, some good wheel-to-wheel action. Like, I know Fatboy was really, really holding you up and doing all, making sure his car it was always in the right place to try and block you.
It won that as well. When I was catching him, I had Venoms behind me, kept overtaking me from DRS as well.
Yeah, fantastic. It was great.
It was mentioned in commentary whether you're actually working in cahoots to give each other DRS every other lap to catch Fatboy up. It was it was good driving.
Okay. Well done. Thank you for proving me right, boy. I knew you would. Now I'll pass the mic over for Beer to interview the second place driver.
Oh, second place, man. A good points haul there for Mr. Hectic. Well done on second place, first of all. It seemed to be a fairly quiet race for you. You just did your own thing there, but 18 points in the bag. And how did you feel it all went for you?
Had a very lonely race. I got passed by Dad and Vemmons on the first lap, and then all the first stint I was on my own. When I came out the pits, I had to pass a few cars, and then I was on my own again for the rest of the race.
Yeah, I noticed you did the one stop. I think it's the one stop strategy you did there. It seemed to work quite well for you, didn't it? Really, when some cars around you were doing the two stops, so you got some very good wear out of your tyres. I mean, how worn were your tyres? I mean, how did you find the wear? Were you losing a lot of pace there, or were you
no, it was quite a comfortable nicely? Race. I think I was on about 60%.
Right, I
hate you.
You still got another 10% to go, at least, probably in both sets then. Well, say it's a good 18 points, though, obviously, with your win at Spain. And also, I believe you got fifth place at Monaco. Your first three races, you got a good haul of points there, 53 points, if my maths is right. So, well done, and a well-deserved second place. And I'll just you're welcome. I'll hand over to Shag to interview our third and final podium finisher, Mr. Pure Vemmons.
Ah, Mr. Vemmons, what a race, son. You gave us something to view. That was some good wheel-to-wheel side-by-side action by yourself. I noticed you did give, I'm sure it was Fat Boy a little nudge at one point. I think he gave him a little tap. I think it was coming into turn 1-2. But there was
probably
nothing much.
I don't know what happened. I just touched the back, and when he spun on cut, then I lost my wing.
Yeah,
then I had to pit for all cross.
I wanted to ask you about that. Did you catch that?
Yeah, well, I did catch an instant actually between Venom's, I think, between Kai and Fatboy going into the Wall of Champions.
This is me.
Yeah, and then I caught Fatboy.
Yeah.
Yeah, we sort of caught the trail end of that, yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway, well done to Vemmons. Nice 15 points. Yeah, I'm looking forward to going to Baku next. No. What do you think of Baku? Do you think he'll do as well?
No. That race is more stressful than Saturday's one. It's all on,
so. You think so? Oh, well. Well, fantastic, though. I tell you what, well worth the watch. If you haven't seen
some quality driving. Some quality driving. And that's not just for the podium finishes. That's throughout the entire grid.
That was from
grid.
Everybody.
Some top quality driving.
Even the people got lapped.
It fulfilled my expectations as being the race of the season, without a shadow of doubt. So, well done to the top three finishes, and well done to everybody who raced with WOR tonight. You're a real credit to the league, and I'm not blowing smoke up your arse. That was quality.
Yeah, was quality. And on that note, we shall say good night to the viewers, and say hopefully you'll join us next week, next Tuesday, where we'll be off to Baku. And also, for let you know that we will be racing on a Saturday, and it'll be 100% race, full qualifying, and I'm sure you'll join in. I'm positively glad we'll be streaming it, so please join in and watch and view, where you'll see me and Beer proving our driving skills.
And yes, we will, number two. I had to get that one in.
Yes, whatever. So, until next time, we look forward to seeing you again. We'll see you about. Thank you very much for reviewing. Bye-bye now.
Toodaloo.
Hey, Cortana, stop broadcasting.
Bye-bye now.